neurodiversity benign polyps. Benign polyps include the amartomatous, hyperplastic, inflammatory, mucosal, and submucosal. So the amartomatous polyp is the polyp with amartya that is a disaster. Here the architecture is disorganized. But the in a appearance, histopathological appearance, there would be hyperplasia of the lamina propria, as well as dilation of cystic glands. There are three syndromes associated with amartomatous polyps. These include juvenile polyposis, Peutz-Jeghers syndrome, and Cowdery syndrome. In this last one, there is rectal bleeding by the polyps, not necessarily because of already cancer, but because of the polyps. In Peutz-Jeghers, there is a hyperpigmentation of macules on the lips, skin, and the genitalia. And there is a family history of colorectal cancer at age very unexpected, low, because this is an autosomal dominant disorder. The patient is at increased risk of developing gonadal cancer, breast cancer, and stomach and pancreatic cancers. In juvenile polyposis, there would be an increased risk also of having a lot of amartomatous polyps. The juvenile polyposis would see also polyps not only on the colon but also on the small intestine. So these are the amartomatous polyps. Now the hyperplastic polyps, they present with a sawtooth appearance on biopsy, less prominent than those of, for example, more common, these hyperplastic tumors or polyps are the most common of, among all the polyps types. These are limited to the superficial layer as opposed to the serrated polyps, and these cells have no atypia. This sawtooth appearance would be also seen on serrated polyps. We will talk that about in other video. The inflammatory polyp, the patient presents either with bleeding or constipation. For that, the inflammatory is less common to develop into carcinoma. The inflammatory polyp could be seen in Crohn's disease, CUSI, but the inflammatory polyp could be associated with inflammatory bowel disease that then next progresses to the civil. The inflammatory polyp could make that the patient with CUSI syndrome then develops colorectal cancer. Mucosal polyp includes polyps with the normal architecture, that is this normal architecture of the mucosa, measuring less than 5 millimeters. And the submucosal polyp present with leiomyomas, lipomas, fibrosarcomas, and the lymphoid aggregates. So the amartomatous polyps are disorganized with hyperplasia of the lamina propria and dilation of cystic glands. Hyperplastic polyps also appears on the crypt, and these have no atypia and they are superficial. Inflammatory polyps, they present with mucosal bleeding with a mucous consistency, or they present with constipation. And the mucosal polyps is measured less than 5 millimeters, and the submucosal may are leiomyomas, lipomas, or fibrosarcomas.